not sure about these cookies. They don't look like you made them. Did you
make those cookies? And with that comment begins Cookiegate. Presidential candidate Mitt Romney was here trying to drum up support in Bethel Park. He made fun of the cookies. It may seem like nothing, but Channel 11's Gordon Lesh found out Romney may have lost some crucial votes.
And you're taking advantage of the cookie gate.
Yes, I figured I might as well.
You might as well.
He wants to be an idiot and publicize you guys, but, you know, it doesn't hurt you guys.
Harsh words today in Bethel Park, one day after Cookie Gate rocked the community. It happened moments after presidential candidate Mitt Romney sat down with local voters yesterday.
I'm not sure about these cookies. They don't look like you made them. Did you make those cookies? You didn't, did you? No. They came from the local 7-Eleven bakery or wherever.
But the cookies didn't come from a 7-Eleven. They came from the Bethel Bakery, a cookie, cake, and pastry landmark since 1955.
These are great. I used to travel from Latrobe to get them, and everything here is fantastic. I think it's a rude thing to say.
I want some of those Democratic cookies. Oh, absolutely.
Now, customers are enjoying the fallout from the misstep.
Well, our current sale is our Cookiegate special. It's buy any dozen cookies, get a half dozen cookies free.
Well, it came from the recent scandal.
Owner John Walsh says he was a little insulted by the presidential candidate's statement and decided to have a little fun with their sudden attention in the world of politics.
You know, we all make mistakes. We all wish we could retract some of our statements. I feel like we need to make him a fan. So I think we need to get some cookies to him when he has time and, you know, let him enjoy it maybe in a non-work situation.
It's still unclear if Romney will get that chance if he wants to take advantage of the Cookie Gate sale. He only has until Thursday. Gordon Lesh, Channel 11 News.